Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing Expendables 4. Let's get into it. It is directed by Scott Waugh, screenplay by Kurt Wimmer, Had Dagger Heart, and Max Adams. The story is written by Spencer Cohen, Kurt Wimmer, and Tad Daggerheart. It is based on characters from David Callahan. It is produced by Kevin King Templeton, Les Weldon, Yariv Lerner, and Jason Statham. The cinematography is from Tim Maurice Jones. It is edited by Michael J. Duffy. The music is by Guillaume Roussel. The production companies were Millennium Media, New Boyana Studios, Templeton Media, Grauman Films, Media Capital Technologies. It is distributed by Lionsgate. The release date for this movie was for United States. It was the 22nd of September 2023, and for New Zealand it was the 5th of October 2023. The runtime for this movie was 103 minutes and 4 hours. And minutes it was 1 hour and 43 minutes. The rating for this movie is for United States it's rated R. And for New Zealand it is rated R16. The genre for this movie is action, comedy, war, thriller, and adventure. The plot for this movie is armed with every weapon they can get their hands on. The Expendables are the world's last line of defense and the team that gets called when all other options are off the table. The cast for this movie is Jason Statham as Lee Christmas, Sylvester Stallone as Barney Ross, Curtis 50 Cent Jackson as Easy Day, Megan Fox as Gina, Dolph Lundgren as Gunnar Jensen, Tony Jaa as Decha, Iko Uwe as Swarta Rahmat, Randy Couture as Toll Road, Jacob Scipio as Galen, Levi Tran as Lash, and Andy Garcia as Marsh. The development of this movie was after The Expendables 3-4 underperformed at the box office. The future of the series was left in doubt, and production stalled over several years. By November 2014, it was announced that the project is being developed with intent to retain its R rating like the first two films. In December 2016, Sylvester Stallone announced that the fourth installment will be the final film in the series. While a scheduled tentative release date was set for 2018, by March 2017, Stallone had left the project and the franchise due to creative differences over the script and direction for continuing the franchise. In January 2018, after vocal support from other cast members including Arnold Schwarzenegger, Stallone announced his return to the series with a post to his social media platforms, confirming new developments on the fourth movie. The reception for the film was, on the review aggregator website Rotten Tomatoes, 13% of 116 critics' reviews are positive, with an average rating of 3.410. The website's consensus reads, "Solid work from Jason Statham and some halfway decent set pieces aren't enough to make up for Expendables' lackluster action and cheap-looking effects." Metacritic, which uses a weighted average, assigned the film a score of 30 out of 100, based on 33 critics, indicating generally unfavorable reviews. My thoughts: Expendables 4 inches left me with mixed feelings. While it's garnered a reputation as one of the year's weaker releases, I found it to be a passable experience. My preference for action-packed films with less emphasis on intricate storytelling and character development worked in its favor. The characters in Expendables 4 met my expectations for this genre. They were adequately portrayed, fitting the mold of action-driven personas. While not groundbreaking, they served their purpose in delivering an adrenaline-fueled experience. The narrative, however, fell short of leaving a lasting impact. It lacked the depth and complexity that could have elevated the movie. While I anticipated a straightforward action film, a slightly more engaging plot would have been welcomed. One aspect that truly puzzled me, and I can't delve into specifics without revealing spoilers, left me scratching my head. It's an element that, when seen, will likely resonate with viewers and potentially raise questions about its inclusion. In summary, Expendables 4 fits the mold of a typical action flick, meeting certain expectations. While the story and characters were serviceable, a few baffling moments left me contemplating its overall impact. My score for this stars, I will give it a 2.5 out of 5 stars. Percentage, I will give it a 55%. Grade, I will give it a C. Out of I will give it a 5.5 out of 10. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this review. I know I haven't done any in a while. I just thought to bring them back, so here they are. Stay tuned for some good content coming your way.